number's too big to ignore.
And I know all of you here know what I'm talking about. Somehow, I have absorbed the message that my body is not safe, even without consciously noticing it until now, that this message is being broadcast loud and clear to women. Fear is the ultimate form of control over our bodies. What are we prevented from doing because of this fear? How much of our mental energy is consumed by this fear that could be better used for other purposes? How much of our confidence and focus is damaged because of this fear? This year illuminated how we women are essentially being ruled over by a group of men. The new leadership within this nearly all-male government wants to curb our right to determine our futures, our right to pursue our own happiness. They want to legislate over our bodies. We need to take inspiration from nature and remember that we hold the mystery of life and the seed of every possibility within our bodies. We need to demand freedom from fear over our bodies and control over our own bodies. And in order to effectively do so, we must seek leadership positions and support other women who do the same. Normal to have at least half, if not more, of our leaders be female. We will be serving and with our taxes financing a government that believes it's within their domain to make decisions for our future. Thank you all for being here and for showing our power to the world, and thank you to the wonderful men who show us that women also have many. The bottom of both hearts beating inside my miraculous female body. I want to thank our new president. You just started the revolution.
Natalie Portman, y'all. To now introduce a trailblazer in the arts community. Amazing artist, dancer, choreographer, director, Debbie Allen.
One voice with you, speaking so clearly in an old conversation. Child, this is an old, old conversation. It's old. This conversation was had by Cleopatra, honey. It was had by Mimi Eisenhower, Ida B. Wells, Sojourner Truth, Harriet Tubman. This conversation that we have to continue to have, that extols the power and the purpose and the value of women. We are born the stronger. Yes, at birth we are the stronger because we're the progenitors of the human race. The landing pad of the human race lays nestled in our loins. Every man living and breathing should pledge allegiance to the birth canal. Now, but don't tell us what to do with it. That's what we want. So today is an incredible day. Mother Earth cleared the skies for us. Yes, she did. You know, we didn't see that storm coming, but we see it now. And we know it's coming again tomorrow. But we will prevail, because goodness prevails. Truth prevails. Freedom must prevail. What happens here today and across this country is sending a clear message to our sisters around the world, women that are standing up just to get educated, Women that are standing up to drive a car. Women that are standing up to pick their own husband. Today is not about anger for me. Today is about love. Love of America, love of who we are as a nation, as a free leaders of the whole free democratic world. With that, we will continue to welcome people from around the world. Look at this rainbow out here. So today, I want to say to you, Melania Trump, you're one of our immigrants that has come here with a dream, and you have prevailed. I'm claiming you as part of this movement. The power of women. Inspiration, joy, light. So with that said, I'm going to bring you a little inspiration and joy. The grace and the power of women. Hang on, one second. Quick change. Go without it. Let's go.
Thank you. after the election. And there was something trending on Twitter that was very confusing to me. I started noticing that a trending couple of words kept appearing on my timeline, and those words were Olivia Pope. Now, I'm not trying to advertise my day job. I'm not here to remind you to tune in. What I'm here to say is that Olivia Pope was trending because people were saying, fix this, Olivia Pope. Something is wrong. You gotta fix this, Olivia Pope. Fix this, Kerry Washington. Fix this, Olivia Pope. Now, being an actress, I should have been excited about that. I was not, and I will tell you why. We are in this situation because people thought a character from television could fix our shit. This is not about Olivia Pope. This is not about anybody saving you people. This is about you and me standing up for our democracy and saying, I matter.
To be connected and unified and strong, and everybody say, I matter.
myself, but I am an American patriot. I am a daughter of an immigrant. And in his words, I love this country. And because I love this country, I hate its blemishes. And in the course of this country's history, the greatest blemish has been how we have treated women and citizens of color and workers and immigrants and the powerless for centuries and continuing to this very day. This new president has said nothing in his campaign or in his long public life to make me believe that those who fight discrimination and intolerance and those who understand science and heed its warnings now have a friend in the highest office in the land. But, as the glorious, glorious Steinem said today in Washington, D.C., there is an upside to this downside, and that is all of us here in Los Angeles, in California, across this nation, and across the globe, joining together to send a message to Mr. Trump. We have not forgotten that you lost the popular vote.
Strong,
strong.
I am invincible.
invincible.
Invincible!
I am woman.
Yeah!
Helen, ready, everyone!
Please give it up for the fierce game changer, LaFon Cox, everyone!
Thank you so much, Cameron. Los Angeles, how are you feeling today? Women's March, how are you feeling today? I feel so blessed, so grateful to be standing before all of you today, to be standing with you today, all of your beautiful faces. And you have all come out today to declare that you will not be silent. And that your voices matter. I stand before you this afternoon, a proud African-American transgender woman. From a working class background, raised by a single mother, I stand before you an artist, an actress, a sister, and a daughter, and I believe it is important to name the various intersecting components of my multiple identities, because I am not just one thing, and neither are you. I believe it's important to claim the various intersecting components of my multiple identities with pride in public, because I've not always been able to do so. I often carry tremendous amounts of shame about various aspects of who I am. And anybody who knows me knows that when I talk about shame, I love to allude to Brené Brown's work on the subject. We know Brené Brown, right? One of the many things Brené Brown says to us about shame is that it is a social construct, that it is created between people and it must be healed between and amongst people. Another thing she says about shame is that empathy is the antidote to shame. If you put shame in a petri dish and douse it with a little bit of empathy, that is a hostile environment to shame. Shame cannot survive. So empathy is so much of the answer today. And if you are a girl like me, a woman like me, a transgender person like me, you live in a country that shames you, that stigmatizes you, that discriminates against you and criminalizes you. Last year in North Carolina, a horrible anti-unconstitutional bill, the so-called bathroom bill, was passed, and it is still in law. It is still the law of the land in North Carolina, and that bill criminalizes me going to the women's room in that state. It criminalizes transgender people using the bathroom that is consistent with how we identify. Trans people are under attack in this country right now. Earlier this year in Texas, a similar bill was introduced into the state legislature, SB6. And last year, over 50 similar bills criminalizing trans people for going to the bathroom were introduced in state legislatures all over this country. Now, trans people have been going to the bathroom for a long, long time. Why all of a sudden is it a thing? They're trying to scapegoat trans people, but I was so moved when Bruce Springsteen and other artists said, I am not performing in North Carolina because discrimination will not stand. I was so moved when so many businesses said, we will not do business in North Carolina because discrimination is not the way we do business. Discrimination is not good for business. And so many people stood with and by the transgender community, and we need you now more than ever. I know, I understand, part of me understands that it is difficult for a lot of people to fully acknowledge trans people and understand that we exist and that we are here. One of the most fundamental things that we learn is that gender is binary. If we acknowledge the existence of trans people, that we have a right to exist in public space, we have to move beyond gender binaries. We have to understand that gender exists on a spectrum. my dear friend Chase Strangio, who works at the ACLU, who's representing Gavin Grimm, he says that these anti-trans bathroom laws are really not about bathrooms. They're about whether transgender people have the right to exist in public space. And I'd like to think that we do. I would like to stand here and declare today that I, as a transgender woman of color, have the right to exist in public space, and we all do. We all do. We have a fight. We have a fight in front of us, but I believe that we can do that together. We can get to those new spaces of critical consciousness together, and it is sometimes painful to come to new places of critical consciousness. After the election in November, I saw so many pundits and politicians, journalists, saying that the progressives lost because they focused too much on identity politics, because they were too politically correct and people felt left out. And I have to say, I kind of took that personally. I was like, oh my God, I think they're talking about me. I'm black, I'm trans, I'm a woman. There were many articles written that said that the Progressive Party sold women out because we wanted to be inclusive of trans people. But what I would say to that is that each and every one of us has a right to exist. I am a trans woman, I exist. Trans people exist. And we must, in order to form a more perfect union, acknowledge the existence of everybody. That's what identity politics is about. It is about acknowledging that people have systemically been left out, and it is time to correct the system, and the time is now. Thank you so much, Women's March. Thank you, Los Angeles. I love you so much.
Representing the most marginalized community in our nation, transgender black women, Laverne Cox. A trailblazer, a supporter of women for many, many years. A supporter for indigenous rights, for human rights, for women's rights, for Black Lives Matter's rights, for social justice rights. A legend in our midst, Jackson Brown.
Thank you. I came to listen. I'd like you to know the names of my two friends here. This is Siobhan Stewart, and this is Alethea Mills. Till I go up there. Shut my mouth till I go down. I'm not gonna shut my mouth. I'm for the truth to come out. I'm the leader with the unknown. Here's a leadership government. Till I go down.
To the killing floor till I am strong.
Strong.
I am invincible.